YouTube, my name is Mesa Sean, and welcome back to another Destiny 2 video. Alright folks, had a rough go this morning, trying to stream and kept getting kicked non-stop. In this video, we're going to go over a whole bunch of the new stuff that's in Beyond Light and Season 12, Season of the Hunt. Namely, we're going to go into collections and check out a bunch of the new exotics, maybe even some legendary weapons. There's a whole bunch of new ones in here. You got to check out this new auto rifle here. Look at this, Arctic Haze right here. Look at that. I love the look of these new weapons here. But we're going to go over that. We're going to go over the season pass. We're going to go over a whole bunch of other new things. I'm still at like mission 1.5 or mission 2. Yeah, I still got to do some more stuff in Beyond Light. I'm finally in the game. It's not kicking me right now. But we'll go check out a whole bunch of new stuff. But before that, a word from our sponsor. Fun factoid, there are 7.5 billion humans in the world that could be playing Raid Shadow Legends right now, and tens of billions already are. Let me tell you why you should be one of them. First off, the game is very addicting, super fun, and there are tons of things to do. Best of all, you could play it on your mobile device or your PC. Do you like challenges? Do you like boss fights? Well, you need to check out the dungeons. You have 10 really tough dungeon bosses to take on, and they are pretty terrifying. You have to complete the awesome story campaign. It's a lot of fun, and there's 12 different campaign locations you can choose from. There are 13 powerful factions, and from these factions, well, you build your champions out of. And whatever faction you choose from, they have some awesome champions for you. There's a lot of strategy in the game, and there's 460 champions to choose from. So you want to collect hundreds of these champions that are unique and also powerful. Playing with friends is a blast, so join a clan and play with your friends. There's over 200,000 active clans in Raid Shadow Legends. And with over 25 million players worldwide, hey, take on the world in the arena, fight against millions of players worldwide. Because of the unlimited customization and tons of different strategies you can use in the game, well, it's endless content and you have infinite ways to play the game. What I like about Raid Shadow Legends is that it's very fun, addictive, there's some thought process into picking out which champions you want to use for each battle or dungeon or story campaign mission, and just going in and wrecking some shop. Raid just released the Artifact Forge, where you could save time and craft artifacts directly, as well as a whole new advanced quest system with amazing rewards, and that's not all. They also brought out some amazing new champions, and they're developing an amazing looking Doom Tower as we speak, which I am super excited about. What I need you to do is go to the video description and click on the special links if you are a new player, because you're going to get 200,000 silver and one free champion, the Grinner, and that comes from the Undead Hordes faction. And it is an awesome champion, especially for new players. You're going to have a really good time with this champion. If you use my special links, all of that treasure will be available for you when you log in on the top right-hand side of the screen where my finger is pointing. All right, guys, good luck, and I'll see you guys out there. Okay, first off, let's check out the Season Pass. And we're going to grab the first package where we're going to get the Duality, the Season Exclusive Armor Set, and the Large XP Boost. So we're going to grab that, and where did our Duality go? There it is right there. So this is a shotgun that fires a pellet spread in hip fire, and then a single high damage slug when you aim down sight. So the other perk here is On Black Wings. Pellet final blows grant a stacking precision damage and reload speed buff. Precision hits with slugs extend the duration. Okay, pretty cool. I'm gonna fire that thing up shortly if I could just put down my good old Outbreak Perfected, which I will shortly. All right, let's take a further look into the Season Pass. So we've got a new currency here. So Recon Data. So it says bring this to the Crow to increase your reputation with him. So yeah, he's gonna be a new vendor. I'm not giving any spoilers right now because I haven't actually gone into the game to see anything just yet. And we could see our usual stuff here. Really not much different in terms of rewards. Like here's a finisher here, the silencing shot. Okay, I like that one. Let me check that one out one more time right here. And bloop, booyaka shot. I like that one. Okay, the usual stuff. They didn't really change too much stuff up here. Yeah, we got some more of the recon data, some more enhancement modules, armor pieces. We got our usual boosts here, Catalyst Quest boost. That's pretty cool. We've got our exotic engrams. We've got a scout rifle here. Let's see this one here. This one is a precision frame. Okay, I like that. 180 rounds per minute. This one comes a dragonfly. It looks like auto loading holster and flared magwell and arrowhead break. Okay, not bad looking. Weapon cosmetics. put a shader. All right, yeah, they changed up the UI a little bit on things here. Let's see what we got on the next page. Duality for the folks who don't have the paid version of the season pass. Just some more of the masterwork bonuses here. Let's see, Crow reputation boost. Yeah, so Crow is going to be a big part of this thing here. There we go, contacting Destiny servers. I'm probably going to get kicked while trying to record this video. All right, level 50, you get an exotic ghost. Let me touch on exotic ghosts because I leveled up mine before just for a goof when I was live on stream here. So now you can upgrade it with enhancement cores, legendary shards, and glimmer. So here on my ghost shell, I like the Eris Morn shell. I put on increased XP gains by 10%. That's the max you can do on a ghost shell, I believe. And also treasure hunter up to 50 meters. And that's going to be 4 energy, 5 energy. Here I put increased glimmer gains by 1%. But you can see there's a number of things. We've got a bunch of telemetry data that you can gather. I guess that's going to be a bigger thing. Well, maybe a bigger thing with Season 12 and Beyond Light. Increased glimmer. You can go up to 35% with glimmer if you have the energy. Resources. We've got loot from public events. I don't know how like good that's going to be. Then here's where the money is. Activity mod slot, which I probably will change this down the road. Like if I go into Crucible, I can get some destination materials. Vanguard, let's see, and Nightfall, extra destination materials, additional piece of legendary gear. All right, so it looks like either destination materials or legendary gear. But let's go back to the season pass. Let's see, we were up to 50. Okay, we got another exotic cipher, and also that No Time to Explain. If you have the digital deluxe edition or the collector's edition, you go see Master Raul, and he will give it to you. We've got some exotic engrams here, glimmer. Nothing really new here. Some raid banners, some armor ornaments are now starting to come up. We've got an exotic sparrow here, the Firecrest. That looks awesome. Custom drive. We've got random mod and destabilizers. All right, I love it. Yeah, that's a cool looking sparrow. Okay, I do like that. And can you put shaders on it? Yeah, you can. All right, sweet. I like that. Okay, that's level 90. You get a golf ball at 94. And then, let's see, you get the victory pose emote right when you're near the end. I like that. With your Izanagis, it looks like there. Or to me, that looks like an Izanagis. And then you get the ornament for your duality, it looks like, right? The antiquity. Yeah, that's the weapon ornament for the duality. All right, now let's go in and check out the collections real quick and take a look at the exotics. Okay, so for kinetic weapons, let's take a look. So we've got the No Time to Explain, which I'm gonna go pick up from Raul. You get that, I believe, after you finish the campaign mission. Okay, so precision shots and shots against combatants slowed or frozen by stasis will return to the magazine. So they got to be slowed or they have to be frozen for this to happen. That's pretty cool. It's full auto. We like that. I like accurized rounds. Then we have time slip. At 10 stacks of rewind again, a small portal will open, shooting bullets from an alternate timeline version of this weapon. Precision hits extend the portal's duration. So looking forward to trying this thing out. It looks different this time. I'm excited to check this thing out. I'm trying to do L3 to hide the menu. There we go. Wow, look at you. The new version of No Time to Explain. Looks like we've got a catalyst for it at some point. I'm sure we'll grab that for Banshee. Let's check out the store too, just in case you're curious. What can you buy for Bright Dust this week? Oh, you can buy the ornaments for the transversive steps, but that's from last season. Anything new that you can buy for Bright Dust? No, looks like this is all old stuff here. I don't want to make this video too long, because then we'll be here forever, but there's a lot of new stuff to buy here. A lot of ornaments for some of the new exotics, which we'll go through real quick right now. Yeah, lots of new stuff here, so I don't want to bore you with that. Let's go right back into collections. Well, first off, now you have this tab here. Well, you have a number of tabs to track your medals. You can go in here and look at all your different medals. Catalysts, too. You can go in and track all of your catalysts, right? Like for my Vigilance Wing, which I've not used in ages. Yeah, I have a lot of work to do for that. Mida Multi-Tool, I need a lot of precision kills with that in the Crucible. I'm not good with Mida Multi-Fool in the Crucible. So, pretty cool there. You've got your lore here you can keep track of, and also your stats, too, for everything. Pretty cool. All right, what else we got to check here? So, it looks like these are... Okay, so for Europa... Yeah, so these are... We got Europa, Season of the Hunt, Your Lifetime, Dreaming City, Tangled Tree. Yeah, so each destination now has its own set of triumphs that you can complete. You go here, you've got your legacy triumphs here, so that's from the past. Let's take a look at collections. Let's look at some new exotics right now. So let's go to kinetics. Now we've got our no time to explain. We already went over that. Sorry about that. Taraba, I never got the Taraba. Rip, but looks like I could probably get that from the kiosk when we ever get to it. So we already went over duality. Here's the cloud strike. So mortal polarity, precision, final blows generate a lightning bolt at the target's location. I was kind of hoping that would be final hits, because if you would hit something over and over, then it would land a lightning bolt on them. But I guess if there's an enemy that you get a final blow on and there's other enemies around them, it's going to put that lightning bolt and maybe do some damage to them. So it looks like it's arc, 140 rounds per minute, and it's got 7 in the mag. What is the other perk? Rapid precision. Oh, here we go. Rapid precision hits create a lightning storm at the point of impact. Okay, I like that. I wonder how big the lightning storm is going to be. Got hand-laid stock, ally magazine, and fluted barrel. Alright, I like that. Power, did I miss anything else here? Just want to make sure. Duality, got you. Power weapons here. Now, heir apparent, you can get this from the kiosk with an exotic cipher. I never got this during the live event, so I more than likely will pick that up, because I don't have it. Hawk Moon, I will just mention real quick, there is a quest for it. I'm going to throw it on screen, an image on screen I covered in this morning's video. We don't know anything about the quest and when it's going to drop, or at least I don't know just yet. As soon as I know, you guys will know, because we will stream the quest or I will do a video on the quest steps. All right, we got Salvation's Grip, the Cryo Cannon. Press R2, hold to charge, release to fire. This weapon's projectiles create stasis crystals and they freeze nearby targets. And you've got 8 rounds in a magazine, 120 rounds per minute. So, we've got polymer grip. That's pretty cool. Flash freeze. Charging this weapon increases the freeze radius and amount of stasis crystals created. So, this one's going to be, I guess, a hold down the fort type of thing. I do not see a catalyst spot here, so it looks like there might not be a catalyst for that weapon. The Lament. I cannot wait to get my hands on this thing. The Chainsaw Sword, which will rip through shields of Barrier Champions. So, you need to rev this thing up. So, hold L2 to rev this thing up, okay? That will increase the damage, shield bypass, and adds shield piercing to all attacks. Gain stacks when dealing damage with revved attacks. Additional stacks increase the damage and damage resistance of heavy attacks. We've got Tireless Blade, so sword ammo granted for every other powered sword kill. And then we've got Revved Consumption. Damaging a combatant heals the wielder. All right, this is, oh man, I cannot wait to get this thing. I'm going to try the glitch out later on, actually, to see if it works, where you can get claim exotic engrams from last season. Expect a video on that when the actual website comes open. As for mods, I think we'd be here forever. Let's just check, let's check general mods. Anything really new here? Head, anything new? I haven't unlocked the seasonal artifact just yet. What about armor? Competitive endgame. Let's see. Where is the new raid set? That should be in here. Okay, the legacy oath suit. So I'm on my warlock, so that's what the helmet is gonna look like. Let's see the chest piece, actually. That looks pretty cool. Okay, yeah, so you could see. Just by looking at it, I wish you could just preview the entire set all together, suited up, but can't right now. So that's the actual raid armor set. Leveling, nothing here. Factions, yeah, nothing here new. What else we want to check out? Well, for weapons, I mean, there's so many different ones. I showed you that auto rifle. Let's see what scout rifles we got. Anything new here? Anything new? It's old. Oh, here we go. The Royal Chase. We showed that before already. Oh, here we go. The Trustee. This one here. Oh, new perk. Redirection. Damaging. Oh, I covered this morning. And this is awesome looking scout rifle. Redirection. Damaging rank and file combatants will increase damage against more powerful ones. This one's a rapid fire frame, so 260 rounds per minute. So, obviously, I think this is the first. This probably is random rolled. Yeah, empty mod socket. Well, oh, that's right. We have two mods. That's right. They changed up the mod system. Now weapons, it looks like you have two systems. Range, handling, impact, reload speed, blast radius, velocity. Yeah, really good customization here. I like it. I like it. Where you going with this, Bungie? Let's look at pulse rifles. I like pulse rifles. I know there was a really cool looking pulse rifle that had a look of the Stranger's rifle almost. Is this it? No, that's not it. Demolitionist. Slideways. Where was that one? I'm gonna hopefully find it. Star in the Shadows, that's it. Star in the Shadows. Yeah, check this thing out. That looks really, really cool. I like that. What do we have? Thresh. Killing combatants with this weapon generates a small amount of super energy. This one's got Outlaw on it. So that's going to be an awesome perk right there. Thresh. I like that one a lot. Hand cannons. Any cool new hand cannons we got here? Anything? Posterity. What do we got here? This one's a 180 round. Ooh, look at that. 180 round per minute. I like the way you look. This one's an energy one, so it's arc. New perk here, one for all. Hitting three separate targets increases damage for a moderate duration. That's a new one, so I'm going to go boom, 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 and then I got more damage. Okay, pretty cool. Any other hand cannons here? No, it looks like just one hand cannon. Oh, no, I see another one there. What are you, the Steady Hand? Okay, that's a reskin. Oh, that's the Iron Banner one. Ah, cool. Mulligan and Slide Shot, just showing on that, but more than likely rerolls. Okay. What do we got here for submachine guns? Anything here? Friction Fire. Any new perks we could see here? Nope. This one's 600 rounds per minute. Could be an alternative to the Recluse. Recluse is 900, I think. I forget. I haven't used a Recluse in a long time. So it looks like we got one new submachine gun. Yeah. How did I never get the exit strategy? That's weird. Oh, yeah. That was the Gambit one. Never got that. Sidearms. Anything new here? Let's see, anything new? Checking. Am I missing anything here? One, two, three. Oh, here we go. This one here. What do we got? New perk. Oh, Unrelenting. Rapidly defeating targets triggers health regeneration. Guardians and powerful combatants count as more than one kill. And that's a cool looking sidearm. And I don't like sidearms. Full auto, steady rounds on this particular version. Bows. What do we got for bows? Okay, we've got... Looks like the Biting Winds right here. Okay, so this one is a precision frame. Pretty cool looking. Explosive head, moving target on the base version. And I'm sure that will roll with random rolls. So that's pretty much all the stuff I really wanted to cover. Yeah, that's the important stuff. Equipment. Yeah, okay, so a whole bunch of new exotic ghost shells. But look at this thing here. I like that. And I love how you can pretty much take any ghost shell you want that you think looks cool and just deck it out with energy and then start loading it up with mods. So that is going to do it for this video, guys. I don't know what I'm going to stream next because it was infuriating getting kicked nonstop. So, hey, I got some clan XP right there. So anyway, if you enjoyed this video, please leave me a hashtag made it to the end. If you did make it to the end, do me a favor. I said do me a favor twice. I always do that. End of the video, so we're babbling. Drop a like in this video only if you see fit. Follow me on Twitter at MesaSean. Check out my stream. Usually and always on YouTube, and that's it. I am out of here like Vladimir, and this week you can get 30% off of good old G Fuel if you use my code MesaArmy. All right, guys, I am out of here.